preparing our individual parts, there was a challenge. In fact, Dr. Adler actually told me, and this is a quote, "I am assuming that you are musicians of the highest caliber." And so, you know, I was, yeah, let's do that. So many of our existing euphonium works are actually rooted in scales, you know, as are most instruments use it. And so when you, and scales have a consistent ordering of half steps and whole steps, obviously. But when you start emphasizing different intervals, like minor thirds, and changing the order of things like that, the technique becomes more of a challenge. Additionally, putting the parts together was, and still is actually, pretty challenging in this work. As you may recall, lots of dialogue in this piece. So putting all of that together, and you know, with all of that, and shifting meters, and virtuosic parts, make it a challenge to integrate together as a group. Now, all this to say, I'm actually enjoying this challenge. You know, like I said, I was actually really gung-ho about that. It's a new challenge, and I was actually really excited about that. So, we're about to perform the piece, but just to sort of guide your listening here, see if you can hear the dialogue that occurs between the different voices as we play. Additionally, try to listen for those more sonorous cadences. So this is a, you know, more of a 12-tone, atonal kind of a piece. However, you'll hear more sonorous cadences throughout. Additionally, I want to show appreciation for my collaborating musicians, Su Young Kim, Sergio Munoz, and Cora Swinson Lee. I'm going to ask them to go ahead and come on up here. Enjoy Sam Adler's The Euphonious Quartet.
Thank you. Thank you.